Do your knees crack or ache? Let's speak to the friendly team at Singapore General Hospital to find out more about knee osteoarthritis. Hi, Nurse Raja. So could you please tell me what is knee osteoarthritis?
So knee osteoarthritis is actually a common arthritis. It's actually a wear and tear of our knee joint. So that's when the knee actually wears and tears, actually that's why we have pain or difficulty moving around.
What causes knee osteoarthritis?
Let me explain to you by using the model of the knee. So in a normal patient, we have this cartilage, which we call it synovial fluid, that actually help us to protect and cushion the bones, and then also allow us to have pain-free movements. While in osteoarthritis, due to overuse of the cartilage actually breaks down due to overuse, or sometimes due to factors such as aging. The cartilage breaks down due to overuse. So the joints actually started to rub against each other. That's where we have symptoms such as pain, swelling, and difficulty moving.
So, Dr. Dawn, please tell us, what are some of the ways we can prevent knee osteoarthritis?
Well, we can prevent knee osteoarthritis by avoiding increasing stresses to the knee, avoiding excessive weight gain, injury prevention, and also avoiding high-impact activities. Activities such as stair climbing, deep squats, running, or even Zumba. However, I would not advocate for patients to have a sedentary lifestyle because this ultimately results in them gaining excess weight and losing muscle tone, which ultimately makes things worse for them. In cases whereby patients do experience swelling in the knees, I would normally advise for RICE therapy for them, which is rest, ice, compress, and elevate. And this normally helps with managing their swelling symptoms, which ultimately reduces their pain.
So what are some of the common symptoms associated with knee osteoarthritis?
Classic symptoms are normally that of knee pain, that is long-standing, that gets worse with time. It is often worse at the end of the day or with activities. The patients also experience startup pain, which is a stiffness that they experience getting up from a sitting position or after a prolonged period of rest. And patients would also complain of swelling. And these are classical, common symptoms that they do present in the clinic.
So how can we diagnose knee osteoarthritis?
Diagnosis always requires a detailed history and a very thorough examination of the patient. So we would go through the history of our patient, asking them about their knee pain, whether they had any injuries in their childhood or any previous knee surgeries performed. I would also want to ask about the nature of their knee pain. Knee pain tends to be mechanical in nature, which means it gets worse with activity or at the end of the day. This knee pain is often not acute, it has been long-standing and affecting them for a long time. And we'll also want to ask them about stiffness, that they may experience stiffness that's worse with rest or getting up from a sitting position. And patients will also complain of swelling whenever they have these attacks. Knee pain often tends to be very localized to the point of affected area of the knee. The knee tends to not move as smoothly, and occasionally we do get swelling. With all these clinical findings, we'll then couple it with an X-ray to confirm our suspicions.
Now, let's dive into the treatment of knee osteoarthritis. Dr. Lincoln, take it away.
So for treatment of osteoarthritis, when patients come and see me, generally the first-line treatment will include physiotherapy, a bit of weight loss, because it helps to reduce the pressure across the knee. I'll give them a knee brace to help to support the knee muscles. Also some anti-inflammatory medication, some painkillers to help manage the pain. Following that, if all of these don't really work very well, sometimes some patients may be eligible for an injection. So these injections actually help to relieve pain, reduce the inflammation, but unfortunately they do not regenerate cartilage. And at some point when the patients become functionally difficult, they cannot manage their life anymore, then we will go on to doing knee replacement surgery.
So Dr. Lincoln, how can surgery be performed?
So we perform total knee replacement surgery, either with conventional tools or with robotic assistance. So today, robotic assistance, we can do it image-based, where the patient has a CT scan beforehand. Following that, there's a pre-operative virtual plan, and then we perform the surgery intraoperatively with aid of a robotic assistance, a robotic arm with a saw. But there are also what we call non-image-based options, where the surgery is performed by developing a plan intraoperatively, where we collect the patient's anatomy during the operation, and then we perform the bone cuts to then resurface the knee. So how that is done, using a model to just illustrate Beforehand, we would actually take points on the knee, and the plan would then allow us to cut the knee. And what we will do is, we will cut the bone into this shape using the robotic assistance, and then we will put the implants on, and the patient will have a new knee.
So what are the implants made out of?
Oh, so the implants are actually made up of usually a combination of cobalt chrome, which is a very strong material, and usually it's paired with a high-quality polyethylene or plastic, which allows very good frictional properties, which then allow these implants to last for a long time. Sometimes we also use titanium in some of our implants, which is like our iPhone 15.
How is recovery like after the surgery?
At SGH, we have the enhanced recovery after surgery pathway for our total knee replacement patients. So after the patient sign up for surgery, they actually go to the physiotherapist to learn exercises that will aid them before and after surgery. During the surgery itself, it's usually an hour procedure. Once it's done, the patients can go back to the ward, and usually on the same day, they can actually start to do some simple exercises and even walking on the same day. By the second day, the day after surgery, they can walk to the washroom on their own. They will be doing exercises, climbing some steps, and they'll be actually discharged on day one. With a physio and the nurses also, they will actually visit them at their home on the first week as well as the second week. And usually the recovery after knee replacement surgery takes about 2 to 3 months. And after that, they can then return to activities of daily living.
After the surgery, would a patient be able to go back to the activities that actually gave him the knee pain in the first place?
Yes, this is a very commonly asked question. So most of my patients, when they come and see me, they are 60 to 70. They like walking, hiking, traveling. And I tell them that they will be able to go back to all these activities. One very common question asked is whether I can squat after the surgery. And I would tell the patients that if they can squat before they go for surgery, they will be able to squat after the surgery. I also get a question about running or jogging after surgery because they are afraid that there's a lot of impact on the implant. But once again, I would tell them that if they can run before the surgery, a lot of times their muscles are strong enough, they can go back to running and enjoy what they like to do before the surgery.
That sounds wonderful. Well, thank you so much, Dr. Lincoln.
Thank you.